Okay, so property worth 1.5 million.
Yeah.
Okay. How much rent are we going to get from it? I know it's anybody's guess, but we got to work with something here.
200,000.
200 grand. Is that fair, reasonable, sensible?
It's a bit high.
Bit high, okay, lower. 100K? 100K is a bit low though, isn't it? 150, yeah, are you happy with that? Are we happy with 150? We'll go with 150, that's reasonable. Okay, so we've got 1.2 million in debt.
Yep.
What's the bank going to charge us in terms of interest rate? A reasonable debt. 4%. Should we go with 4%? So what's 4%, my friend, of 1.2 million? 48,000. 48,000? Yep, you're right. So you're paying 48 grand every single month, and this is pretty much where I am with Boston, by the way. Remember, I get 140 grand. Remember, I said that. Okay, and we're paying 4.84% to Interbay, 4.64 fixed for 5 years. So I'm here or here or there or thereabouts. So now let's call this 50 grand to keep the numbers easier. You've got 100 grand cash a year, which is again where I am with Boston. So I'm not too sure which bit you're saying isn't going to work, but happy to kind of.
Well, I just think in terms of like your balance sheet, because your balance sheet has still got a registered debt of 1.2 million.
Yeah, that's right. But
that
yours
never changes.
You can pay yourself for that.
But you don't care about that. Leave the debt there. You're all.
The debt's just sat in the background. It's not.
The debt sat on your balance sheet. Your balance sheet says I own 1.5 million pound worth of assets. On that, the 1.2 million is owed to the bank.
So the asset scrubs off the debt.
Yeah.
Yeah. That makes more sense.
Because you got two things. You got your P&L, profit and loss account, which has income for the year, expenditure for the year, profit for the year. You've got your balance sheet, which is your rolling, okay, assets and liabilities.
Yeah.
You don't care too much over here, as long as your liabilities don't exceed your assets.
Yeah, sure.
Okay.
Is that 50k service in that loan?
Yeah, no, yeah? I get that. So it's just the debt bit. But then, so you've got multiple SPVs now, so you've got four or five, and each one of those is generating a profit. Like, how do you structure that to pay yourself in a tax efficient way?
Again, it depends on how much income you need and how many people are involved, but you'd obviously use up your personal allowance every year. If you have loaned some money to the company, you can charge some interest.
Yeah.
There's some savings there. On top of that, you would take a 2 grand tax-free dividend.
Yeah.
If you have a husband and wife, they would do the same.
Already with my tech company.
Yeah.
But I'm just wondering if you do a particular thing with splitting it across multiple companies. Or if you just,
that's not going to help you. Yeah.
And then if it's like on a pay away, you just have pays you in on one company, I'm guessing.
To pay, that's right. And the other ones, you have
dividends
because you don't pay national insurance. Because for your personal income, it gets lumped together at the end of the year.
Yeah, I understand that.
Yeah.
That's what I was just trying to clarify.
Yeah. So are you kind of happy with that?
Yeah, that's good.